Everyone, welcome to Parkinson's Disease Education. Today we're going to be talking about stiff man syndrome, or actually, I guess the PC way to put it would be stiff person syndrome. And in all fairness, that is the actual disease name, stiff person syndrome, or SPS. We're going to be talking about stiff person syndrome versus Parkinson's disease in 5 minutes or less. Timing. So what do we know about stiff person syndrome? You may not have heard of this condition. And I had honestly not heard much about it until Celine Dion was just diagnosed with this condition within the last, well, at least we knew about it on the news in the last week or two. So I'm going to break it down for you, and we're going to compare and contrast briefly. All right, so what do we know about stiff person syndrome? This is the breakdown. It is a rare progressive neuromuscular or neurological disorder. It may result in folks having an abnormal or a hunched posture, as well as potentially issues with balance problems, poor balance reactions, and reflexes result in falls. It affects women at a 2-to-1 ratio, so twice as many women are affected as men who have this disease, even though it is rare. It's often misdiagnosed as Parkinson's disease, MS, fibromyalgia, or in some cases, psychosomatic illness, anxiety, psychosis, basically psychological disorders as well. You could easily see by some of the symptoms that we listed why it would be mistaken for Parkinson's disease. People tend to get stiff, they have muscle spasms, they have poor mobility, they have balance problems. It's very, very similar. But one of the things that contrasts from Parkinson's disease is the biomarker involved. In the case of stiff person syndrome, there's a biomarker called glutamic acid decarboxylase, or GAD. GAD is in fact an antibody. So an antibody is typically something that's only present with an immune response. So this is our own body attacking something, right? So you think about lupus and other conditions like that, it's an autoimmune disorder. Rheumatoid arthritis is another example. There are often biomarkers that indicate those things. The autoimmune response in the case of SPS tends to be in the brain and spinal cord, hence the neurological damage that can occur. One of the things that's interesting as well is that attacks of SPS can be triggered by stress. Loud noises, emotional stress, and other stressors external to ourselves can result in somebody becoming more rigid and more stiff and painful if they have SPS. So what can be done about treatment? Well, the treatments involve oral diazepam, especially if anxiety is a potential cause or stressor that's resulting in attacks. The other medications that might be prescribed would be baclofen or gabapentin. Those are medications that tend to relax muscles or spasms. And the other thing that's been found to be effective is IVIG, IV immunoglobulin. That will result in a suppressed immune response. So it basically cuts down the body's own attack on itself and can potentially mitigate symptoms somewhat. So that's what stiff man or stiff person syndrome is in a nutshell, and how it compares to Parkinson's disease. Now briefly, I wanted to talk to you about the fact that Parkinson's disease does not have autoimmune biomarkers, at least not the same one or similar one to stiff person syndrome. The GAD or glutamic acid decarboxylase is not found in high numbers or in high quantities in Parkinson's disease. In previous episode of the Parkinson's Warrior podcast, we talked about the SYN1 test. The SYN1 test helps to rule in or rule out Parkinson's disease at an alarmingly high rate on either end. So basically, it's extremely good at ruling in or ruling out Parkinson's disease. And essentially, alpha-synuclein is a protein biomarker that is something that is seen in the SYN1 test that can rule Parkinson's in or out. If it's in high levels in multiple areas in the body, and out if it is not found. In summary, it's really easy to mistake stiff person syndrome for Parkinson's disease. There are some that have been diagnosed with PD for years before they find out it's actually something different, most likely because it's not responding to traditional treatments to PD, such as levodopa and other treatments. If you like this video, please like and share the video with other people. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think and what other questions you have about disorders related to Parkinson's disease or other topics. And as always, please subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss future videos or get and so that you get notifications of those videos as soon as they become available. Thanks for watching and be empowered.